Hola amigos, soy Blanca, your online Spanish teacher, and I'm here today because it's jueves, Thursday, and do you know what it means? It means that it's time for another mini Spanish lesson. And the mini lesson today is gonna be the second part of a mini Spanish lesson series that we started last week. If you remember, last week we started the Spanish marker series mini lessons. Markers are those small words that you put them in your speech when you are speaking, and they have several missions. That's why we are doing a series of them, because they can be used to introduce a subject in Spanish, to put your ideas in the right order, to finish an end to your speech, and so on, so on. If you remember, last week we studied markers to introduce a subject in Spanish. This week we are gonna study markers that you are gonna use to put in order your ideas in your speech when you are speaking. I know that you probably will know some, but I'm gonna give you a variety of them so you can choose from and enlarge your Spanish vocabulary. So if you are ready, let's see some marcadores en español para indicar orden. Uno, antes de nada, before anything. Dos, para empezar, to begin with. 3. A continuación. Next. 4. En primer lugar. En primer lugar means firstly. And it's very similar to our 5. Primero. Primero, that means first. So, en primer lugar, firstly. Primero, first. 6. En segundo lugar, secondly. And as before, we could say en segundo lugar, that means secondly, or just segundo, that means second. 7. Luego, that means then. 8. Después. Después means after. 9. Finalmente. Finalmente, equivalent, the English equivalent is finally or eventually. 10. En último lugar. That means lastly. And 11. Y último, para terminar. To finish. And that's the best way I can say that we are done with this lesson. Para terminar, I hope you enjoyed this mini lesson. As always, I'm gonna give you some links in the description below so you can get some extra resources or you can get in touch with me, whatever you like. And also, I would love, love, love to hear from you. Let me know in the comments below if you find this mini lesson series useful. If you use any of the markers that we have learned today. And lastly, por último, o en último lugar, I would like to ask you something. I would love you if you could pick one of the markers that we have seen today and make it your own. Use it as many times as you can until you master it. I promise you that in no time, it will be like saying your name. So let me know in the comments below which one is your fav or which one is the one that you can't wait to start using it. So I hope you enjoy, and I will see you next jueves, Thursday, for the third part of these mini lessons about markers in Spanish. I hope you have a good day, and I will see you pronto. Adios!